This is what it looks like if you've learned an algorithm but not trained it for speed solving. And here's if you did. Learning algorithms, or learning anything, is a matter of information and recall. If you're more of a beginner, you'll be focusing more on the information part or how to get an algorithm into your head. Recall is about retrieving that information from your head quickly. So let's start with information, or how to memorize the algorithm. So you want to start by breaking down the algorithm into smaller or more memorable pieces of information. For example, these R moves always go up followed by down, then up, then down, and the U moves go U, U, U2. So we've condensed the information, and now it's a lot easier to go through it without messing up. Now, for this PLL case, you can't condense the information the same way, but you can do it a different way. Instead, we can visually watch what this pair does as we go. So we start with an F move, put the pair here, remember just U prime, and then put the pair back. And next we focus on this pair, we take it out like this, and then we put it back in and fix that block. You can also try and remember what your fingers do. So in this algorithm, these four moves in the middle, that's a sequence known as the sexy move. Now the four moves right before it are actually the same thing, except for instead of a U prime, you do an F prime like this instead. So how you can think about it is you're starting with the same four move sequence, except one of them ends with the left hand doing this, and one ends with the left hand doing this. And you can remember the next part as down right hand, up left hand. But once the algorithm is in your brain, you want it to just be muscle memory. The slower you turn, the harder it is to build up muscle memory, so try to turn fast as you practice. The next part is recall, and that's the difference between this and this. So there are two main differences between these two. The first algorithm had a choppy execution, but the second one was really smooth all the way through. We've all been in this scenario before where you're practicing an algorithm, it's going really well, and you just keep doing it over and over, and even though you're really confident, you come back to it later and you kind of stumble on the parts. When you're practicing an algorithm through repetition, when you get to the point where each time you can do it perfectly, then you're not really being productive every time you do it perfectly again and again. The better next step is to put the cube down and come back to it later. You'll still be pretty good at it, but you'll notice some parts that you're very obviously bad at. Then you can focus all your energy into that part, come back to it later, and repeat. Doing an algorithm over and over doesn't force you to recall it because your brain just holds onto that information and keeps using it. You need your brain to put that away and then come back to it later and ask your brain to look for it again. So if you have 10 minutes to practice an algorithm, I guarantee you the worst thing you can do is just do the algorithm for 10 minutes straight. If you practice it till you're good, stop for a while and go again and repeat, then you will also be training your recall, which makes your algorithm smoother in the future. Now the other difference in these two examples is the first one had a really slow recognition of what I was supposed to do before I started. In the second one, I saw it, reacted, and went in right away. For each case, you have to practice associating the visual with the algorithm. So you might be thinking, to practice that association, I could just set up the case. Let's think about how I'm going to do that. And then I see the case, I do the algorithm, I've practiced the visual association. Well, kind of. If you're trying to set up a specific case, you probably already have the algorithm in mind, but in a solve, it goes the other way around, so you're practicing the wrong thing, which means it's not actually a visual that triggers your memory. So you need a way for a case to just show up in front of you, be surprised, and then go straight into it. And that's one of the main reasons why I made the jperm.net algorithm trainer. And you can trust that this is legitimate advice because I don't make money from this website. So briefly, how the website works is there are algorithms and you don't have to like those ones, you can change them yourself. And then you can also click on the pictures to choose which ones are ones you're learning and which ones you have finished learning. Then you can head over to the trainer, which by default can show you any algorithm in this category. So we are in PLL, so it could give me any PLL as my next one. But you can customize this to be only certain groups that you've learned, or only the yellow cases, which are the ones you are working on, or the ones you're working on and the ones you've finished. That way you can mix them all together and see if you still remember them. Then you just follow the scramble, you get a case, and you're forced to look at it to recall the algorithm. And if you've forgotten an algorithm, you can click the right arrow key and it shows you what the first move should be. Or if you've forgotten the whole thing, you can keep pressing right and it shows you the whole thing. Also, as long as you use the same browser and don't clear your browser storage, then all your custom algorithms and your times will stay on the page. So what I like to do is learn maybe three algorithms at once, start training all of them, and then start mixing it in with other groups, and then eventually with the whole group. So I know training algorithms kind of sounds like hard work, maybe not as fun as doing actual solves, but then again, how are you going to get faster without putting in hard work? Also, besides repetition, you need good finger tricks to make the algorithms fast. So you can check out the videos on the end screen to help you with that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.